Landforms. Landforms are physical features formed on the Earth's surface. In some places, the land is elevated, whereas in some, the surface is plain due to natural processes taking place regularly, like the weathering, water, erosion of the soil. There is a constant change in shape of the earth. There are two types of landform shaping processes, internal process and external process. Number one, internal process. The earth beneath our feet is made of three layers, core, mantle and crust. The crust and upper mantle are known as the lithosphere. This lithosphere is not a single piece of a layer. It is broken into a number of plates known as tectonic plates. For example, any major change in the tectonic plate causes earthquakes. Number two, external process. The change in the shape of mountains, plateaus, and plains happens due to external factors like rain and wind. These are also the external processes. Moreover, soil erosion, also known as denudation and deposition, are natural processes changing the surface of the earth. Let us have a look into different landforms of the earth. Number one, mountain. The mountain is the highest landform on the surface of the earth. It is usually found to be conical in shape with steep sides and a pointed tip called a peak. The highest mountain range in the world is the Himalayas with the highest peak. That is Mount Everest. There are three types of mountains. Number one, fold mountains. They are formed due to the collision of two tectonic plates. The Himalayan mountains and the Alps are examples of young fold mountains. Number two, block mountains. They are created when large areas are broken and displaced vertically. Rhine Valley and the Vosges Mountains are example of block mountains. Number three, volcanic mountains. They are formed due to volcanic activity, example Mount Kilimanjaro in Africa and Mount Fujiyama in Japan are example of such mountains. Number two, hill. Hills are lower in height than mountains, but are higher than their surrounding areas. They are generally covered with green vegetation, which is good for crop cultivation like tea and coffee. Example, Shivalik Hills, Annamalai Hills, etc. Number three, valley. Valleys are the low-lying areas between two mountains or hills. When river flows down the mountain sides and hillsides, it wears off the rocks and fertile soil, due to which they are covered with thick and green vegetation. Example, Kangra Valley, situated in Himachal Pradesh, is the largest valley in India. Number four, plateau. Plateaus are the elevated landforms with steep sides and a flat top. Plateaus can be formed by a number of processes, including upwelling of volcanic magma, discharge of lava, and erosion by water and glaciers. Example, Deccan Plateau is the largest plateau in India. Number 5. Plain. Plains are large areas having flat surfaces. They receive a good amount of rainfall and are covered with various trees and plants. Agriculture is mainly carried out in the plains as they have fertile soils. In India, we have the eastern coastal plains and the western coastal plains. Example, Indo-Gangetic plains. Number 6. Desert. Deserts are large, dry and hot areas of land which receive little or no rainfall throughout the year. The vegetation is scanty due to the shortage of water. The main vegetation found in the deserts are the cacti and the baobab trees. Sand dunes are found in the deserts, which are huge hills of sands formed by the winds. Example, Thar Desert, Sahara Desert, etc.